Martin takes one-man industrial action when rumours fly that the market is being moved, although Carmel says it's in the very early planning stages. He goes on strike, but no one else will join him, and after some cross words with Stacey, he reluctantly heads back to his stall to more drama with Carmel. Jay and Billy are stuck in traffic en route to pick up a body. Time for a heart-to-heart about Star and Jay's love life. Will Billy's wise words help him move on? Max has spent the last few weeks building bridges with his family and trying to settle back in. But we all know Max. What's his real game? Kim overhears Emerald asking Vincent to talk to her about her attitude to Denise, and Kim explodes and throws her out, so she moves into Denise's. As the residents carry on with their lives, a disaster hits Albert Square. It's bedlam, but at least it makes the residents rally together when they realise it's worse than first thought. What exactly's happened? Stay tuned. Next, we preview events in Corrie. Steve is feeling out of his depth dealing with his grief and Michelle's anguish, and she slaps him down when he suggests going out for lunch. But then she changes her mind and gets done up and asks him to take her to the bistro, where she proceeds to get drunk, makes a scene, then runs out. Steve and others rush off and search for her, but it's Robert who gets to her first, and vulnerable, she leans in for a kiss. Will he take advantage? She tells him she wants to visit Rory at the Chapel of Rest, and she unloads her grief to him. But then Steve arrives, and the couple finally face up to saying goodbye. Peter has a row with Nick when he picks him and Simon up, and Nick manages to really hurt the lad when he flings the door open. Liz is horrified to receive the Moses basket she ordered for Michelle, so she hot-foots it around to Leanne, but Nick is less than happy when he realises Liz knows the baby is Steve's. Nick makes a big decision about his, Leanne and Simon's future, but Peter's unlikely to let them move without a fight. Last, we see what's brewing in Emmerdale. Kane is alarmed when he sees Debbie and the kids on a crime program, but before he can find out more, she shows up, begging him for help. What's she done now? Later, while Sam babysits her two kids, two men burst in looking for her and realise the two children are perfect collateral. Can Debbie get the money by 5 p.m. as they demand? Meanwhile, can Kane keep Ross away from Debbie? He uses a carrot and a stick by threatening him and offering him money, but that's too simple. Debbie opens up to Ross and asks him if he really loves Rebecca, but it's obvious they are still in love. Fasten your seatbelts. It's left to Gabby to look after Ashley when Laurel's out and his carer calls in sick. And while Doug and Diane step in to help short term, Laurel needs help. She's forced into a tough decision while Ashley's confused about what's happening. Chaz is furious when she thinks Patty spoiled her plan with DSYs, while Pierce continues to make Rona's life hell, ramping up her guilt and her anxiety.